My name is Cam, and today myself, Jake, Ben, and Carr are going to be presenting our two pitch ideas, and they're called Resurrect and Testament. So first of all, we're going to start off with Resurrect, and here's some information of the product. So our film is going to be based on Matthew's interpretation of Judas portraying Jesus.
The modern version is a gang of thugs from Swindon, and they attack and kill an ex-gang member who betrayed them 3 years earlier.
They think he's dead and leave his body in the street where they left him, but no, he was only unconscious, not really dead.
He later comes back to life and hunts down every gang member that attempted to kill him.
So now I'm going to speak about the treatment. So our format and runtime, so the format is film and the runtime is going to be about 50 minutes long. So the synopsis is a world that only knows betrayal and violence, and a man called Dave betrays his longtime friend called Sean after a deal with another gang went wrong, which resulted in Sean's closest friends being killed and taken into prison. Later on, Sean comes back to kill Dave, but Dave is near death and suffers life-threatening injuries. Dave awakes from this near-death state and begins a long saga of vengeance upon his name. So I'm going to start by speaking about the first key scene. So 3 years after Dave betrays Sean and escapes to his freedom, Sean hears about Dave is in a location that is close to him. Sean rallies his gang members and briefs them about what's going to go down. After this happens, the gang members are ready and begin to find Dave and bring him to justice, in their opinion, after Dave's betrayal in the first place. For our second key scene, Dave is walking down the street minding his own business, living his new life, and suddenly a large group of people start to come down the street. He's wondering what's going on, and he notices the group leader at the front, which is actually Sean. At the moment in time, all the flashbacks that happened 3 years earlier begin to rush through Dave's brain, and they come back to haunt him. As Dave fears for his life, he begins to run, and only hope can save Dave now. For our third and final key scene, after Dave awakes from being brutally savaged by the gang, he finds out that Sean is in a location called Swindon from an unknown source that tells him a load of information about what's about to go down and what Sean's doing. He finds out that Sean is having another deal with another gang in an abandoned building. So Dave goes to that place and sees an opportunity to kill Sean when he's on his own. He looks Sean in the eyes and says to him that finally your time has come, and pulls the trigger and finally kills Sean. So those are some of our ideas and key scenes. And now I'm going to pass you on to Ben, who's going to speak about the characters in more detail.
So for the characters, Davis is out seeking vengeance as Sean and his gang who attacked him in the street and left him for dead. He meets people with common interests and goes to take down the gang who harmed him. Well, the next character I'm going to talk about is Sean. Sean is trying to get back at Dave, who betrayed him years ago, getting two of his gang members killed and one arrested in the standoff, all over money and respect. The next character is Danny. Danny was Dave's best mate back when he was working for Sean before betraying him. He died during the standoff, and Dave has never forgiven himself since. He was Sean's best member. Michael is Sean's bodyguard after Danny died. Michael follows Sean's every move and doing all his dirty tasks for him. He was the one who started beating Dave in the street fight. I'm now going to talk about the form. So my adaptation idea is based on the resurrection story in where Jesus is crucified, and then 4 days later on Easter Sunday he comes back to life. In my adaptation, the main gang member, Jesus, gets shot but fakes his own death. In section 3, he then attacks them 4 days after the fight. To keep it related to the story, I've decided to use the original biblical names, similar to the modernised Romeo and Juliet, where they speak in Old English. This adaptation follows Todorov's theory, with 3 different sections. The first section where there's a problem, the second section where they begin to resolve it, and then section 3 where Jesus gets his revenge after having the gun pulled on him and faking his death. hand you over to Kai, who's going to speak about the content.
So the genre of our film is crime due to all the activities in it, assault, drug dealing, murder, etc. This means that Resurrect also follows the action genre due to the violent fighting throughout the film. The ideology of the murder is prominent throughout the narrative as a whole, due to the character's goal of getting vengeance and killing all the opposing gang who attacked him. Examples of iconography in my film are mask, weapon, and tracksuits, the tower block where it's set, visual effects, and the language and slang we use throughout. So we're going to use a lot of close-up camera angles and wide shots to show and improve the narrative in the film. So the style of the film is going to be quite urban and abstract, and using loads of like locations in cities like Swindon, Manchester, and Birmingham, in like tower blocks and stuff, and like lots of sound effects of footsteps and screaming and fighting will be used throughout. I'm going to pass you over to Jake to talk about the positions in the market.
Our film is targeting an audience to 15 to 25 year olds due to the content of the film, so like we give it 15 classification from the BBFC. The film will be predominantly targeted towards men due to the dominant behaviour, male protagonist, violent nature, language, and criminal content in the film, which is prominent to the codes and conventions of the action and crime genres. Constraints and opportunities. When it comes to feasibility, the adaptation would be possible to develop into the film because of its modern setting and issues in the film that are raised. So we're not in need of scarce resources for the film's production. The costumes are of a typical youthful lower class outfit, including items such as tracksuits, trainers, gloves, etc., which means they are affordable and most people own some and be able to provide it to the production of the film. Locations are mostly quite popular public sites where people can walk past and could potentially obstruct shots during production and affect the actor's ability to perform. As the actors would also be using weapons such as guns and knives, etc., members of the public who are unaware that filming is taking place may report to the police or borough council, which could cause a legal and ethical issue when filming. Due to the people amongst the background, it could also add to the ambience of the film, and it is useful for adding unpaid extras. Opportunities. Due to the changing of contemporary cultures, we can be more creative and adapt the older story to make them more relatable to our chosen target audience and fit the genres required. This means I am able to add additional story lines to make the narrative more compelling to a wider audience. With the implementation of the new characters, we have the opportunity to use VFX and SFX during gunfight sequences, also with the use of sound design and music to add dramatic emotion to the story and helping to develop the narrative further.
So this is my first two panels for the storyboard for Resurrect. So as you can see in the first one, they're in a garage which is set out as a gym, which they're using to work out and prepare for this fight. And it's going to be filmed sort of a wide angle shot with a little bit of camera movement to make it seem more like, not seem less professional, but more sort of to the style that we're going for. And then for the second panel there, I've got the main character who's just there smoking a cigarette, and it's close up, and you can sort of see he's sweating, and you can sort of see the stress in his face, which gives a proper feel for the sort of vibe we're going for our movie.
These are my two panels of the fight scene storyboard where Sean attacked Dave. In the first panel, Dave goes to hit Sean and protect himself, but Sean leans out of the way and has a fight. And then onto the next scene is where Dave finally gets knocked out by a gang after they think they killed him, but he's absolutely dead. These shots are going to be mostly static and not moving, but there'll be a bit of camera shake to add action and emotion to the story.
So this is my only panel for Resurrect. This is at the end of the film where Dave finally gets to kill Sean. As you can see, I'm going to be using low-key lighting. I've said in the mise-en-scene that it's going to be an abandoned warehouse. As you can see, Dave is shooting. Sean, I'm going to be using a middle shot so that I can, so the audience can clearly see everything that's happening in that scene. And yeah, with Foley, I'm going to be using gunshots, screaming, but I want to emphasize the falling and the blood splat. So that's my panel.
This is my only panel. This is during the fight sequence at the beginning. Dave's trying to being constrained by the other gang members when he punches Sean. Set in a black alley, and yeah, I'm using a mid shot. That is the whole sequence can be quite fast panning motions, and can use it from a variety of different angles. The shots won't last that long to create fast pace, high intensity, the fight sequence. Feasibility?
So with the feasibility, we feel that because we're close to all of these urban locations, we can fulfill making our film fit the criteria, making sure that the film looks like a crime film using cities such as Swindon and Birmingham.
We'll be working on a budget of £150 that we can spend on locations and actors. This will help us to secure locations as owners would be more keen on letting us film in these locations, such as Coffee Wine and Swindon Town Centre being one of our chosen ones.
We haven't had a lot of experience with visual and special effects, so we feel that we'd be struggling to make it look realistic in the fight scene match and like blood splatters and gunshots effect.
We're also going to be creating our own Foley so that we can make the scenes sound as real as possible, which will mean that the viewer can hear every detail in the fight scene.
So this is our feedback. Would you watch this film?
Are you asking the audience that question right now?
We're asking that.
Yeah, possibly.
What would make this film more entertaining, would you say?
Can I just ask a question about your target audience? Because can you describe your target audience again?
15 to not 50 year olds. It's associated with quite a wide target audience. I'd say maybe more lower class because they can relate to it.
But there was something very specific that you said earlier.
Well, it's mainly targeted towards male audience.
Why is that?
Because of all the protagonists, but this is essentially a male cast, mainly, and the violent nature of the film. I don't know.
What, girls don't like watching violent films? Can you construct some...
I would say men like violent films more. I'm saying that girls don't. I'm just saying it appeals more to the male audience.
Do you think you can, given that your audience is all female, do you think you can construct some more useful feedback questions? Would you watch this film? Is, I don't know, it's not that useful to you. Maybe something along the lines of, do you think is it more appealing to you if a film's got strong female characters, which ours doesn't? Would be an interesting question, given that you've already acknowledged that your target audience is going to be mainly men, and your audience for your pitch is all female. That's what all I'm getting at, is just try and get under the skin of that comment that you've made about violent films. No, I want you to just do it right now. Like, ask these questions. Now, don't change your questions, just ask different questions, because would you watch this film is... Lauren said maybe.
We had a female character.
Yeah.
What would encourage you to watch this film?
It was more like shooting violence,
had
like an actor alongside it.
Yeah. Okay. Are you able to relate to any of the characters at all?
Would you be able to relate to them if there was female characters though?
Right. Would you recommend the film to your friends?
You get some
right,
great feedback.
So, idea two.
So now we're going to talk about idea two, which is called Testament. So here's some information about Testament. So our adaptation is from three biblical references, which are Genesis, the creation story, Genesis's Adam and Eve story, and then Matthew's interpretation of the Judas betrayal of Jesus.
Our adaptation is going to be split into three chapters, beginning with the creation, developing to the story of Adam and Eve, and then Jesus' betrayal. Over the film, it develops into changing new styles, and the film doesn't follow the normal film conventions, as we want to have a higher chance of winning the pitch competition. We want it to be a bit more individual than that with its structure.
These three chapters go through a similar way as the original stories do, but we have modernised them so that our modern day audience can understand and relate to our film.
We also think that having the film to be presented in this way will make the film stand out better as well.
So, the format is a film, obviously, and we feel that to show this film the way we want it, we feel that having a runtime of 45 minutes will do that to make sense to our audience. So the synopsis, Jake said, we've split the film into three different chapters. So first and foremost, we're going to start with chapter one. Basically, the film opens in a low-lit studio where a hooded figure sits in the center of a room. He's surrounded by litter which contains papers, tapes, and lots of studio equipment. This is the tools that the creator will use to create the other chapters. The figure begins to type into the typewriter, and the narrator will discuss the creation of new worlds and the power of imagination, which then leads on to chapter two. Chapter two is about Adam and Eve. We're introduced to the characters Adam and Eve. We see this significant moments over the following weeks throughout the story as Adam and Eve love for each other progresses. They begin to explore further and further in this new paradise, and one day Eve is tempted to go into this abandoned and forbidden building to explore. She walks inside the dark derelict cottage and meets an elderly and weak man, who in this case is a heroin addict. She turns around and sees the static television playing in the corner of the room, which appears to amaze and brainwash her. There's a syringe of heroin dose that is placed in front of the old television. Various images of nature and serenity are displayed on the screen. Eve watches in fascination. The old man tempts Eve into taking the dose, which then brings in all of the bad suffering, pain, disease, and poverty which plays on the old television. The man disappears, who is essentially the devil, and Eve runs to find Adam shortly after, beginning to notice that their beautiful paradise is now inhabited by other people, which then leads on to chapter three, which is a world turned violent, crime-ridden, and drug cultures. So chapter three is about Jesus and Judas. Judas is a man surrounded by greed and crime and violence who works for the biggest underground drug gang in London. Judas steals a shipment of drugs to sell to a rival gang for more money as Judas becomes greedy and greedier and doesn't think about the consequences that are ahead of him. When the gang leader finds out, Judas blames his only friend Jesus, who was in the gang but managed to pay his way out and now is a good working man. So Judas blames Jesus as his only way out and puts all the blame as Jesus puts the blame on Jesus to get revenge for him leaving the gang and also threatening Judas's life. So in our first key scene, we will see the creator In the first key scene, we'll see the tools that the creator uses to create the new universe and the new utopia. We will see, we'll show this by using the typewriter and this Eastman Kodak camera that shows the, so the viewer that can understand as the adaptation will be modernized. For our key scene two, in this scene we're going to show the way the devil can tempt mankind. In this scene we will see the old man tell Eve to take the dose of heroin, which will lead the new world to destruction, greed and crime, as Eve went against the creator's rules, leading to the world to change. And finally, for our key scene three, in this scene we'll see the torture scene that the drug gang inflict on Jesus. Judas starts to feel a bit of remorse as Jesus is being tortured, and as this happens, Jesus tells that he was set up by Judas. Judas calmly tells the boss that he is a loyal servant to the gang and didn't want out like Jesus, therefore leading to Jesus' death. Judas then tells the gang leader that he'll kill Jesus himself, and looks Jesus in the eye and gives him the kiss of death on his forehead. After Jesus is killed, Judas goes back to his everyday life without feeling any remorse or feeling guilt inside of him. So now I'm going to pass you over to Ben, who's going to talk about the characters.
So for the characters, our main character is the creator. He's a filmmaker and writer who's constructed the following scenes that we see in the film. He is the creator of this imaginary world and the story that we see, and like God, he is a visionary artist. Our second character is Raul Santiago Caballo, a man who controls the streets and only cares about his drugs business and will stop at nothing to gain finance and hopes to expand his business across other regions in the world. Adam is the first man to be created in the creator's image and the first protagonist in the story. He is placed in the city of Eden with Eve, who he eventually falls in love with. Adam is a little more cautious than Eve, however, just as young and naive. Eve is the first woman of existence. She is placed in the city of Eden with Adam, who she eventually falls in love with. Eve is a little more adventurous and daring than Adam, which leads to the making of a terrible mistake when she is tricked by Satan in the appearance of a feeble elderly drug addict into unleashing evil suffering and pain into the world. Satan disguises a weak, elderly, homeless heroin addict in pain in order to grab the attention of Eve. He then tempts her into taking a dose herself and brainwashes her with a supernatural static television. This drugs Eve and appears to unleash the old man's evil powers. Jesus was in the gang from a young age. He started going up the ranks with the gang. During this time, he worked very closely with Judas and they grew up together in the same neighbourhood. Jesus wanted out of the gang and eventually got his wish granted by paying their gang leader, Santiago, a large sum of money and swore to take their business to his grave. From there on, Jesus got his life back on track, became more religious, and begins to work for a news outlet company. Lastly, Judas is a character who is loyal and a good servant to the underground drug gang and would put the gang before anything. But his character begins to change as he isn't receiving his usual payment averages. Over time, the culture and greed for money his boss shows appears to influence him and inspire a materialistic view, and he eventually decides to turn on the gang and his lifelong friend, Jesus. Now I'm going to talk about the form. So in this adaptation, we're going to be using Todorov's theory, as the film will start with an equilibrium and end with a new equilibrium. We decided to follow this theory because we felt that it would best suit the adaptation to showcase the different stages in the film. I want to make my film very emotive and use this theory, and using this theory will definitely help. The main biblical reference is Genesis. The adaptation is based on the beginning and the story of the creation of the world. This develops into the story of Adam and Eve. The other religious parts we have is Matthew, Mark 1, Luke, and John. Further on in the story, the film features an adaptation based on Judas's kiss of betrayal and Jesus' execution. The adaptation shows a modern interpretation of his biblical lectures. The story is told through the eyes of a filmmaker slash writer who creates this world, which is torn apart by Eve's mistake. The utopia is turned into a world riddled with greed, addiction, and stimulation. A modern society dealing with high crime rates out on the streets and drug culture. I'm now going to hand you over to Kai to talk about content.
The testament will use and follow the closing conventions of the crime and action thriller genres due to all the criminal activities undertaken in the film. Due to the violent aggressive nature of the protagonist, the testament also follows the action genre due to the violence and fighting occasionally found throughout the film. Some examples of ideology used in the film are guns, laboratories, fast cars, dark clothing, urban and rundown environments, and visual effects and effects. So for chapter 3, the style we're using is quite urban abstract crime, with close-ups of the characters to symbolise the narrative and emotion, establishing shots to show location. We've also got screaming, gunshots and sound effects, also knife cuts and that. So I'll pass on to Jay to talk about the target audience for this new marketing place.
Third position in the marketplace, I would like to see my film in multiplex cinemas such as Empire and Cineworld. I would rather have my film screened in a multiplex theatre rather than an independent cinema because our target audience includes a wide range of viewers, therefore be more suitable in a variety of multiplex cinemas around the country rather than a local independent or community cinema. For target audience in my film, I want my target audience to be between the ages of 14 to 50, as the genre of the film isn't suitable for an age of 14 and below. I also believe that anyone older than 50 may not be able to relate to the society depicted in the storyline. My film does not appeal to a specific gender, as I wouldn't want to discriminate it to either of the two. Any mature individual can relate to this movie. I want people of the middle and lower class to watch my film because I believe it is widely targeted to multiple audiences of this class would be able to relate to more, would be able to relate more to some of the ethical issues raised in the film. I feel that people from classes D and B on the demographic table appeal to the most. Constraints and opportunities. The first two chapters in the film are perfectly feasible, however the third chapter may be slightly more challenging. This is due to less dialogue scenes being in the third chapter and more consistent action sequences. Some constraint issues for original ideas in the film may include getting permission to shoot at these chosen locations, getting actors, actresses and suitable for certain roles in the film. When it comes to feasibility, the adaptation would be possible to develop into a film because of its modern setting and issues in the film, so are not in need of scarce resources for fast production. The costumes are of a typical youthful lower class outfit, including items such as jackets, tracksuits, trainers, etc., which means they are affordable and most people will own some or at least be able to provide them. The locations are mostly quite popular public sites where people can walk past and obstruct shots during production and potentially affect the actor's ability to perform. This would be tricky when trying to give the effect of an uninhabited world. However, we are going to shoot early morning after sunrise when locations are less busy with people and decrease the risk of shot obstruction. As the actors would be using weapons such as guns and knives, members of the public who are unaware the filming is taking place may report it to police or complain to the borough council. This would cause a legal issue when filming. Amongst all these issues, having members of the public amongst the background could add to the ambience of the film and is useful for having unpaid extras.
So with further development, we decided that we would create a spin-off about Judas. And the title would be Judas, the Evil Within. With the synopsis, we want to showcase how Judas was as a young boy. So, Judas as a young boy was brought up into a world full of evil. His mother tries her best to keep him away from this crime and debt, which lives just outside their doorstep. Judas, age 13, joins his first ever gang. The once innocent boy now goes down the dark path to becoming pure evil. With our film Testament, we feel that we want to create a spin-off film about Judas. We want to do this because we feel like having a spin-off film about this character will give more insight into the character's life and how Judas thinks and feels in the film Testament. This means that our viewers who have watched Testament can understand how Judas became this man, therefore getting rid of any rumors
or theories about this character. So now we're going to talk about the storyboard. Sorry. These are my six panels. This is going to be at the start of chapter three, which is Judas. All of these panels are going to be a quick montage about how he gets ready for his day. So I'm going to be using a wide range of middle shots and close-ups to emphasize what he's doing, getting up and getting ready in the morning. The mise-en-scene in the scene is going to be mostly set in his bedroom or the bathroom, using high key lighting.
This is my six-panel storyboard. This is during the opening scenes, introducing the audience to the creator's workspace and his studio, where he creates this imagined reality in which we tell the rest of the story. So you've got like a few close-ups. There's quite a few dolly and trap shots in this. I want the film to be visually, like storyboard-wise, take inspiration from films like The Revenant, kind of like Alejandro's style, a lot of fluid track movements, a lot in the film. But yeah, mainly wide shots and a couple of close-ups. But yeah, the storyboard basically just shows him setting up a typewriter, putting in a film reel to his camera.
My storyboard then shows the panels afterwards where he sat at his typewriter and he begins typing out the beginning of the story. So as you can see, the first one, he types out on his typewriter, "Let there be light," and then an LED light turns on in his low-lit studio, and after that he begins creating the world. I've sort of used close-up shots for the typewriter shots, but with the first shot of him actually typing, it's quite far out to sort of show a distance from the character at the start, until we get to know what he's actually doing, and then when he begins typing, as you can see, the shots become more close up.
This is my sixth panel storyboard for the creative monologue at the start of the film. The first one is going to be a blank phrase, flat, so it adds more mystery effect to while he's walking, and it will cut to where he walks into his studio where he's creating the scene for the film. The camera will track in pan to the left following his movement. So we'll cut into a close-up of his face behind a typewriter. You'll also use medium close-up while he's typing on the right left to add more effect and atmosphere moving before finally fading to another back three where he continues the monologue.
So this is our feasibility. So with this film, we felt that it would be really easy to make as we're setting in urban street locations, for example London, Swindon. This means that we have accessibility to these locations to make the film fit the theme that we want to go for. Furthermore, in terms of costume, because the film is a modern adaptation, we'll be dressing the actors in modern clothing, and like the clothes that kids wear, people wear in this generation.
With the crew, I'll be having my group with me today, and having some friends of mine which are actors that I've used before in previous films. So we won't have to go through the process of casting, which will save time on the production. In terms of budget, we'll be working on a £150 budget, but we'll be chipping in on travel and lectures when filming.
In our film, we're going to be using some effects in the fight scenes, as I want to make sure that the gunshots look realistic as possible, so the viewers can feel like they were there in the scenes, which leads me onto the sound design music.
With the music, we're going to be using music from producers such as Tony Anderson and Zach Henley, because their music that they create is the type of sound that we're looking for, as it's very emotional and deeply thinking. I think that I can bring new characters into my film, for example, Jesus having a family that we haven't seen before, possibly having Judas with a family as well, as this can create more diminution to the film and make the film more interesting for the viewers.
Show some feedback. So, do you guys feel that this is an accurate representation of the biblical passages?
Do you believe we have used narrative form effectively? Do you think the characters have been developed well? I mean, obviously, like most of the characters, they use the same biblical name, barely even a change. Try to keep them as accurate as possible to the original story. Do you feel the visual and audible tone of the movie is set right? Do you think it could have a potential of being like darker or more light-hearted? Considering the first two chapters are more like drama-based, and then the third chapter is where it intensifies.
Okay, listen, guys. One of the pass criteria, the description of the pass criteria is that you're doing this pitch for feedback. So far you've got a couple of nods, maybe half a sentence. You're not getting the feedback that you need to pass. Like, you're doing a really, really good pitch, but unless you get some useful feedback, you're not going to pass. And the next assessment criteria is a pass merit and distinction on how you use that feedback to develop your idea. So you need to get some feedback that you can use, otherwise you're not going to pass this criteria or the next one. Okay? So think about ways that you can rephrase those questions or try and get some kind of, inject a little bit of energy into this situation somehow, like maybe ask more open questions, get your audience to discuss your questions for feedback a little bit more, something like that, but you need more than nods.
Do you guys like the sound of the film? Like, is it a film that you would go to the cinema and watch?
I would watch it. I think it's quite interesting, like the take we did on the Bible story. I think it's quite creative. So.
If you could develop the story differently, particularly after the second chapter, because obviously in the second chapter we're introduced to this now inhabited world full of all these new characters. Where would you take it from there differently, other than telling the story of Judas and Jesus?
Maybe add like a chapter between the second and third, it's kind of like a dramatic difference between the second chapter and the third.
Yeah, it's quite a sudden end, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you feel that like we could add any other characters into the film at all? Because obviously we've got like we haven't got a lot of characters involved. Do you feel it would be like more interesting if we had a wide range of characters?
I think if you added more characters, it'd get too confusing. So I think you should just stick with the ones you have.
They won't. Okay, so the first idea was
the first idea was
like John Wick, some gangster who. Have you seen John Wick?
No.
Oh, you should. Well, none of you. That's because girls don't like violent films.
We do, but it's like theirs is a bit dramatic. I'm gonna be honest.
Too dramatic.
Just a little bit. Like,
too much.
Well, I feel like it goes off like the biblical reference a little bit with like all the drug lords and like.
It's a little bit confusing, like what the main storyline was.
Yeah.
There's so many chapters in the other films.
In the second story.
Yeah.
The first story was really simple. It was just a gangster who, I don't know, fallen out with his gang friends and then kills them all.
Yeah.
The second story was about. Is it about.
It's about the great 7 days of creation.
Yeah.
Then Adam E. Then. The Judith Betrayal, and I think that's a big jump from the beginning of the Bible to the end.
Is it like two separate
nothing
stories?
In between.
Like, was it
three even, wasn't it?
The fruit of the creation, there's the 7 days of creation. And then there's when Adam and Eve attempted.
Luke's just literally just told me that you only need to gather feedback for your second idea.
Okay, that's what we've all done for, don't we?
So,
which,
that's fine anyway.
I don't understand what their primary idea was.
Their primary idea is the second one, the Adam and Eve, the long one.
Okay.
So
yeah, I just think it's a little bit confusing with the different stories.
Mm.
And just the big jump from the beginning of the Bible to the end of the Bible.
Mm. So too much in one story. And he said it at the start of the second idea that it was going to be 45 minutes, didn't he?
I mean, and it could be like Harry Potter, where they've got like Deathly Hallows, Hallows Part 1 and Part 2. They could do Chapter 1, Chapter 2, Chapter 3 as different movies. Maybe it would like interest people more.
Because I thought like 45 minutes is quite long for a short film. And like, I think the Adam and Eve idea is really good. Like, I think they should just stick with that one. I mean, I still think the other idea is good, but just for a short film, it's a bit too long and complicated.
Mm.
And I don't know how they'd fit it all in if they wanted to shorten it down.
So it's not just a question of... You're questioning the way they've developed the idea, but you're also questioning the feasibility of it.
Mm.
Yeah, okay. Okay, well, I guess that's going to be really useful feedback to them. But I understand why maybe you're reluctant to talk about it in front of them when it's not positive feedback. Have you got positive things that you can say about the idea?
I think it's a really good idea. Like, I really like the Adam and Eve idea and how it's like showing like the reality of the world and stuff. I think it's really creative.
And I did like the three different chapters.
Because
I like that, it's like three stories of one.
But you could maybe do it in a simpler way so that even within that adaptation of Adam and Eve, that there are three distinct chapters or something like that.
Because I think if they make it more distinct, it would be like really good, and as long as it like flows all together and like just, because I couldn't see the link between the stories, like how it just cut from Adam and Eve to the next bit. Like, I mean, I can understand kind of the way it's linked, but it's just a bit like different.
So it's more like an anthology than one story, isn't it?
But I do think it's a really good idea.
Okay. And I don't want to go on and on about it, but do you think, when you're talking about target audiences, do you think that it's useful to think of it as targeting men over women or women over men? Or is it more useful to target like age groups and kind of social class groups or income groups?
Maybe like age groups, but then stereotypically men, because obviously men are more drugs and writing stereotypically, but you can't really say that. So maybe just like the age group compared to like gender.
They're quite a like large age range, like because the difference between like their likes with the different ages, because it was 15 to 50.
Yeah.
So they obviously like different things because different ages.
Normally, when you're talking about target audiences, you don't have such a broad age range, really.
But then it might, it can, what's the word? Like, anybody likes, like, the genres?
Yeah, of course, like, anyone will watch
it,
but that's not the target. Yeah, there's a difference between the target audience and the real audience, and obviously, like, you get people of all ages interested in all genres of films and music and TV and stuff, but that's not who's being targeted. So normally I think like 16 to 24, like late teens, early 20s, is a bracket of people that would be targeted. Okay. Okie doke, thanks for that.